Hello. Welcome to the sixth episode of the series, Modeling REM from the anime ReZero. In this video series I'm bringing my workflow from the REM character modeling process. In this video I will be bringing an anime style toon shader tutorial and NPR techniques. Let's start by switching the layout of the blender to shading. First of all we must have light in the environment, and activate the lights. Since we have no material, we will create a material before creating the nodes. When creating, these nodes come by default, what will be used from them is only the output. We can rename the material to stay organized. To add nodes, just press Shift plus A, this menu will open. By clicking on the search button, we can search for the nodes to be used. The first to be added is Diffuse BSDF. Now the shader to RGB. The next to be added is the color ramp. Then the RGB mix. With that we can already make a basic toon shader. We will only need to change the base color and shadow. In color ramp, we change linear to constant. With that we already have the basic shader ready. If we were to use this basic shader without textures, we would have to create more materials. There would be a lot. As all the colors we need are in the texture, we will use only one material. Now the next node I'm going to add is image texture, which can be found in textures. Or we can use the search field to find it easier. Use Shift plus D to duplicate the node. To add the texture, press the Open button. It will open the window with the files and folders, just locate the texture and press Open Texture. On the second node I did the same thing, just added a different texture. In the first node, we have the base texture, and in the second, the SSS texture. The SSS texture is linked in the shade color, and the base linked in the mixer base color. This way as shown in the video. Now the colors will be controlled by the textures. Now the next node added is the UV map. Here we will have to place the UV map that has not yet been generated. The next node is mapping. In type, we will configure vector. It should be connected to the texture nodes. And UV map, connect on mapping. Thus. In texture I will be changing flat to smart. That's because I want sharp textures. Flat usually blurs textures. Now we are going to create the UV map. In edit mode we select the vertices and press unwrap to unfold. This created the UV map. We can now add in the UV map node. The configuration of the nodes for NPR style tune shader is ready, and it will stay that way. If you want, just pause the video to copy. We can position the light to check the shaders working. We must add the material created for all objects that make up the model. This process will be accelerated because it is not so difficult to do. Now we are going to create the material that will be responsible for the external contour. To do this, press the plus button to add material. Then in new, to create a new material. Let's add the node first, issue. Then transparent BSDF. And right after that, geometry. And now the mix shader. The nodes will be organized in this way. Now, let's connect them in the following way. Ready. The nodes should look like this. Just pause the video to copy the layout. To change the color of the outline, just do as follows. And the color of the outline is changed. Now we are going to place the outer contour. For this we are going to use a modifier. In the modifier tab, we are going to add the solidify modifier. I'm going to rename it to outline. Adjustments should be made as follows. Normals, press the flip button. In materials, we will put the value 2, which refers to the amount of materials we have. In thickness, we will adjust the value we want for the thickness of the contour. Ready. With that we already have the external contour of this object. Now what we have to do is add the modifier to all the other objects. Try to rename them all with the same name assigned in the first one. We also have to add the material for all objects in the model. After adding the modifier solidify on all objects, and rename it with the same name. We can copy all the settings made in the first modifier that we added at the beginning. Just select all the objects, and leave the first one to select the last one. Now, I'm going to add a third material that will be for the eyes. I usually do a separate texture just for the eyes. The nodes must be created in the following way that I will show. Staying that way. You can pause the video again to copy the layout. Now we must assign the material of the eye to the vertices of the same. For this, I will select the vertices of the eye. We must have the UV map of the eye and configure this map in the UV map node of the eye material, as I showed before. With the vertices selected, and the eye's material also selected, just press the assign button. With that, this episode ends. In the next one, I will be doing the UV mapping. I hope you enjoyed the video, thanks for watching, and until the next episode.